Here we go. You ready?
Yep. Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Here we go.
It's getting higher.
It's getting higher.
It's getting higher.
It's high.
Look at how much. Hold on. We're going to let it, because right now the sand is going like this in the water. It's dancing too. But you know what it's dancing to? What do you think?
Jiggling.
It's doing the popcorn.
popcorn.
Oh, wait. Look at Liam's finger. Now look at the jar and tell me where the sand is at. Move back a little bit so other people can see.
No, it's doing to what, Coco?
Okay, Alexis is touching it. Put your finger there, Alexis. Okay, now look. The sand did what?
Went down.
It sank. The water did what, Liam?
Rise.
It rise. And the rocks stayed at the
bottom.
So we know then that matter occupies space. Okay, you can stop.
You can do it.
You can. You want to do what? Here's our experiment. So this is what I want you to do.
If you wiggle como una Coca-Cola in a bottle, y cuando lo abres, it goes up. Y se cae.
¿En una Coca-Cola?
No, cuando está en como una botella y cuando se mueve, se va para aquí y se
cae. Sube, que sube. ¿Qué tiene una Coca-Cola? Tiene
una tapadera.
Y tiene gas. Es agua con gas. Entonces, si le haces así a la Coca-Cola, ¿qué sube? El gas sube.
Y también
si se te
cae. Y te vuelven los bubbles.
Las burbujas. Ok, this is what I want you to do. Here we go.
It's going to be the Spanish guy.
Okay.
I don't speak any Spanish. Oh, I thought that's what she said. I suppose when I sort of start looking at it, I just think, well, it's hard for me because I'm used to working with data that has a lot of stuff around it. So, so not understanding kind of where this experiment comes from or kind of what the environment is. I mean, it's a school, but is it kind of after school or is it for a particular kind of student? So there's some kind of contextual information that I'd normally have. I mean, it doesn't mean I can't look at the video. But also for me, I kind of think it's just a recording, so it's not data in any way, it's just this material. So what question am I asking of this data in order to begin to start kind of looking at it? So just to come to a 2-minute clip in that way is quite different than I think a lot of us would normally be working in. So that's something that I'm thinking about when I'm watching it. Like, what am I actually looking at? Yeah. What happened before this? What's going to kind of happen after? What work went into constructing this particular little group working together? And it seems like, I suppose, looking at the data, I'm looking at the video, I'm thinking, well, they look quite used to doing this, like the children. So I suppose I'm trying to get a sense of what's a normal practice in this environment. They're not kind of not sure where to sit or... So
yeah,
I'm kind
and
of
some
getting,
are lying down. And
yeah.
It looks very relaxed and ordinary to them.
Yeah, so it's kind of like I can see from some of that context from the video that this is like a normal practice, that it's nothing new, they know how to behave. But so one thing as well that I'm kind of looking at is what are the rules of this little group and how an experiment gets done in this group.
Yeah.
And I think, I suppose I felt something I thought was like, oh, why is that little girl holding her hand up when everyone else isn't holding their hand up? So is she new to the group? Is she new to the group and she doesn't understand the rule that you can just say what you, when you want to say something, you just say it? Or is it that the other people are breaking the rule that you're meant to put your hand up and speak? So I'm kind of trying to understand the rules of the group, this practice. And so that's one thing that I'm thinking when I'm looking at it.
Ready?
Yep. Yeah. Okay, here we go.
gotten higher. Getting higher. It's high.
Look at how much. Hold on, we're gonna.
So, and both thinking about like the teacher-student relation that kind of sets up that social environment. I'm also thinking, oh, okay, that's interesting. The children think they can instruct her. That wouldn't happen in every little group like this.
Yeah.
So they're telling her how to hold the jar and that correcting her, and but she's not responding, which is fine.
Because right now the sand is going like this, and it's dancing too. But do you know what it's dancing to?
So I just want to take it back, because I'm not sure if, so when she's doing this action of the sand is dancing, and then she says it's dancing too. I want to know if the little boy that she's responding to when she says it's dancing too started that or responded.
Yeah, where did the demonstration come from?
Yeah. Did the demonstration come from him moving? Did it come from her and he's responding? Or is it just something completely different and she's pulling it into her story? So that's why I'm rewinding.
He's going like this, no, it's dancing too. But do you know what it's dancing to? What do you think?
So I don't think he is dancing when she says that. So maybe he normally is just jiggling around.
Yeah, maybe you would have to go back to before she begins it, if it's in response to that.
Yeah.
So now she's totally finished the pouring.
Yeah.
It's high.
Look at how much. Hold on, we're going to let it, because right now the sand is going like this, and it's dancing too. But do you know what it's dancing to?
So he does something, but I think he does it after she offers it to him.
Yeah,
dance,
so he's
right?
kind of picking up on, so maybe he's, maybe, I don't know, like kind of picking up on this idea of movement, so he's kind of moving as she is kind of thing, and then she pulls.
So in a way, he would be, he with his body, he would be completing something she started, and she detects that.
Yeah, and pulls it into
and
her
then,
kind of narrative.
That's
yeah.
really cool. Yeah.
So I think that's kind of, so in the sense that they're correcting her, she's kind of watching their bodies as well and drawing that into the kind of narrative.
What do you think?
Jiggling.
It's doing.
And then when she said jiggling, or he says, or that child says jiggling, and she says it's jiggling, I kind of like, I suppose that kind of jarred with me because I was thinking, what kind of word is that to use in a kind of this experiment? Like, is she trying to. What's she trying to do then? She's talking about the sand dancing, she's talking about it jiggling. Like, she could have said, just thinking about everything as a choice, she could have said, well, can sand jiggle? Can sand dance? You know, she could have, I don't mean she should have, but she could have kind of put a more scientific or, you know, like very early years scientific label around that. So. Because of what it's moving and it's, you know, like, I don't know. So I think that's interesting that she's just taking the
popcorn.
And then she brings in this popcorn thing that everyone would know about, the kind of movement of popcorn.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's a bit confusing because that popcorn does that because of heat and she's not kind of engaged with heat. So I kind of think what to her was the relevance of bringing in popcorn. I mean, something they would all probably have seen, someone making popcorn.
So I'm realizing now that I don't exactly know what the physical setup is. So she's pouring sand into rocks
water.
With water over them?
I think she's... Yeah, let's have a look what she's doing. I think she's pouring some kind of dark sand into water, but she says the rocks are at the bottom. But it's not clear if the rocks are in that... jar.
So this could be rocks on the bottom and
water. Yeah.
And then this is a jar of sand.
Yeah.
Here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Here we go.
Yeah, it's a dry granular of sand.
No, that was
it's rocks.
Yeah. So she's got
rocks
mixed.
And sand into
she's
water.
Got, yeah. But
so the question might be, what's going to happen to the sand and the rocks in this water? How are they going to layer out as sands? Okay.
So...
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotten higher. Getting higher. It's high.
Look at how much. Hold on. We're going to let it, because right now the sand is going like this, and it's dancing too. But do you know what it's dancing to?
And this little person with their finger on there, they're kind of, so I don't know exactly what they're looking for. I think they're looking for, they're anticipating. I suppose they're not saying anything. But if we can see their kind of this sense of like measuring something or
yep.
some kind of level, so they're anticipating what's going to happen.
Yep.
So you could see that as a kind of actional kind of or gestural hypothesis, if you like, without
yeah.
even saying anything. So.
And they as someone has been saying, it's getting higher.
Yeah.
Higher, and then someone else says, it's high.
Mm.
Is the process
what do you think?
Changing
yeah.
the stuff?
Yeah. It's doing the popcorn.
popcorn.
Oh, wait. Look at Liam's finger. Now look at the jar and tell me where the sand is at. Move back a little bit so other people can see.
There is good hot cocoa.
Okay, Alexis is touching it. Put your finger there, Alexis. Okay, now look. The sand did what?
Went down.
It sank. The water did what, Liam?
Rise.
It rise. And the rocks stayed at the
bottom.
So we know then that matter occupies space.
So I think, I don't know if they do know that matter occupies space, because I don't know if they know what, so something must have happened before where she, I would imagine, where she introduced the word matter
mm-hmm.
to them and
mm-hmm.
space. So she goes from this very kind of everyday experiment and language of jiggling and popcorn and dancing to a scientific
mm-hmm.
kind of, both a more more formal teacherly gesture of pointing
mm-hmm.
and kind of up and down from this kind of jiggly dancing thing, to kind of make a statement. So I'm interested what happens now. She's kind of changed the tone
mm-hmm.
of things
mm-hmm.
in a way.
Okay, you can stop. You want to do what?
So I don't know, when she says you can stop, she means he can stop touching the jar.
Mm-hmm.
And then this little one who hasn't said anything or
comes
doesn't
in
think yet comes in.
Maybe
and
even holds the point. Yeah.
Yeah.
Here's our experiment, so this is what I want you to do.
And that little one's trying to do it as well.
So it's at a pace your earlier conversations, it's interesting that these kids are, they're actually taking on their own lines of action with
mm.
the apparatus.
Yeah.
That early on they're telling her kind of what to see
mm-hmm.
and how to do things. And now they're back at it.
Yeah.
Since
yeah.
she's released it from its
yeah.
instructional role for a moment, you
yeah.
know? And it's kind of back at it.
If you wiggle como una Coca-Cola en un bar, y cuando lo abres, it goes up. Y se cae.
¿En una Coca-Cola?
No, cuando está en como una bote.
So that would suggest that girl, so that little one who's talking now about the Coke bottle, which is about gas, and so then the teacher is sort of saying, well, that's water with gas, and I think kind of saying it's not what we've just looked at. I'm not sure. So that, because it's very different what the little one's talking about.
Mm-hmm.
So, but she's still translating the Coke bottle into a like water with gas in it, so liquid
right.
and gas. So she's still translating it into a like school science kind of.
Although
discourse.
in the Coca-Cola case, I'm wondering if she's kind of disqualifying or assessing the model the girl is proposing,
mm.
which is, I think the girl, now that I'm looking at
yeah.
this English translation, the girl is kind of saying, like, if you shake up a bottle of Coke, it rises.
Yeah.
And then it will later fall.
Yeah.
And just as there was a rising of the water
mm-hmm.
earlier in this.
Yeah.
Yeah. And maybe the teacher is now distinguishing Coca-Cola from what's going
yeah.
on in the sand
yeah.
and rock and water mixture. Because
yeah.
there's a significant role for gas.
So whereas before, when she was talking about some matter, but it's not, I mean, matter could be gas.
It could be,
it?
Yeah.
So it's like, so she's responding to this one, but I'm not sure what that means to the kind of. So you can start to see, I suppose, just thinking about analysing it, so you can start to see
yeah.
these different kind of end points when everyone sort of shift away,
yeah.
when the kind of tone of the discourse changes from being everyday to sort of slightly school science,
yeah.
and when it moves from being in English, and I mean, imagine all of the children speak some kind of Spanish, but I don't know, kind of, then those, these different kind of shifts. So if we were making a transcript, then we could start to kind of think, well, where do the episodes, even within this 2 minute bit, start and end? Like, how could we pass out the different bits of the video? And then kind of think, well, what, start to think, well, why can we see them as distinct moments? And what is it that each moment or part of the video is doing? Like, and then what would you kind of name them as eventually? What kind of, in the terms of like learning something about school science, or like, what is it that's being learned, if anything, in those different kind of moments? So, just look at the end.
Que sube. ¿Qué tiene una Coca-Cola? Tiene
una tapadera.
Y tiene gas. Es agua con gas. Entonces, si le haces así a la Coca-Cola, ¿qué sube? El gas sube.
Y también
se te caen los
bubbles. Y después los bubbles.
Las burbujas. Okay, this is what I want you to do.
Right, so for the whole of that time, that little girl, like child, has her finger on that thing. And I kind of think that's the kind of, seems like before when Liam had his finger on the jar, it was kind of commented on and responded to, but it's not, I wonder if she's waiting for something to kind of, I suppose that would
I know,
make
it's
me think.
Like a very important next moment. I mean, if not, then she's sort of come late to the to the collaborative demonstration or something, and she's holding part of this thing in place, but it has no future in the conversation, which would be kind of sad.
Yeah.
But
so
maybe that the next thing that's going to be picked up is...
Yeah, or maybe it's like the, maybe it would be, or maybe she'll, I suppose that those kind of moments are interesting, like how do they get experienced by the student? Do they get experienced as being ignored, or do they get experienced as, oh, next time I better do it a bit earlier? Or what's the kind of understanding of how everyone's meant to interact there? So now I was just going to watch it again with no sound on it and look at the teacher's gestures. Just because sometimes when we're looking at video, we watch it quite a lot without any sound on, just because it's sometimes easier to see the patterns in the gestures that are happening and the kind of changes in space. So. I just think there's a kind of, there's also in here, I suppose, just only in 2 minutes, it's so short, like these kind of different tempo of excitement as well, like.
There's really a cluster of something here. Mm. There's something, everyone knows something will be visible.
Yeah.
Otherwise, why would this be happening? And so they all know to be watching for something.
Yeah, so in a way, she's kind of, experiment has this place, as it does in all school science, of being exciting. But I also think at the end, I think this little child, I think this child says, I want to do the experiment, I want to listen to it again afterwards. And she said that was the experiment. So I think that, did you hear that?
Oh.
Right. So we're doing
okay.
it again with
well,
sound
we
in a minute.
To pull that out. I thought when she says, that's the experiment, I thought she was transitioning into, we could do experiments with this apparatus, as opposed to the experiment is completed, but you're possibly,
let's see,
that's,
because just in terms of thinking of, you know, almost like if you were to draw like a kind of, you know, like a notion of excitement, do you know what I mean? You could almost think of like the timeline, if there's like this moment where everyone's all inside, and then kind of later, when there's just her engaged with like this child, and there's this one, kind of touching the pot, and everyone else is dispersing, and it's all gone. Do you know what I mean? So it's like this kind of sense of how can you kind of
visualize? I mean, even if you were to make snapshot drawings and you marked as best you could every child's gaze, this spread of arrows would show you exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah,
that's very cool. Because this cluster, you know, this little puddle definitely disperses.
Yeah.
Several
Let's
times.
See exactly.
I also think it's interesting that she's protecting that She's protecting the apparatus from unwanted action by kids for the instructional purpose, and then she's going to kind of let it go later, right?
Like everyone's, like, it's all, you can see this, I think it's starting to kind of fall apart now. But anyway, so I think that's all very, very, there's nothing, no, in terms of kind of thinking about the gestures and the movement, there's nothing, I don't mean there should be, it's not a judgment in that sense, but I wouldn't describe any of those as in any way translating or transitioning into something scientific around movement of materials in water, for example.
Yeah.
But I would say now she's moving into a very into a more
so,
instructional,
right.
like with this kind of, and it's just classic kind of.
Yeah. She actually leaves blanks in her utterances, right? So she starts with the subject and the predicate, and then she leaves the object open
mm-hmm.
for them to complete.
And do they?
Yeah, to be checked. That's funny, there's these kind of cycles
so,
of looking that come back and then fade and come back and fade.
So I suppose if I were doing a transcript, I might like to have these little kind of screenshots down the side that show that,
mm-hmm.
and then I would use that to go back into the data and say, well, why is it that the kind of pull of the experiments faded now? Like, why is it getting looser?
Mm-hmm,
like,
mm-hmm.
what is it just that these are young children and their attention span's gone, or is it that they just can't see anything happening? Like the point
you know,
that she's
it would be
demo.
Wonderful
yeah.
to be able to mark a video record up like this.
Mm.
I'm going back to the arrows,
which
you didn't attach them to viewers, but if we took them to be gaze lines of sight. If we could overlay that and they were shifting about, that would be like really informative about the record, you know? So so you turned the sound off and then that would be adding markup to the that could be dynamite.
Oops. So now I think she's getting, but in a way as well, I suppose I'm finding it hard to understand what her gestures mean in the context of teaching something about science, because they're about something going in, but that's not, so they're kind of, she's kind of gesturing what she did, she put something inside something.
It's almost like she's replaying a possibly visible sequence of states in the physical jar.
Yeah.
And she's including her actions.
Yeah.
But then I think what she wants to produce out of that, I'm remembering the talk, is that these things settle into their levels, into their layers. But how exactly that would get you to the point of now knowing that matter occupies space is another question.
Yeah, because it's interesting, any experiment's interesting like this, because you're trying to demonstrate something that can't be seen.
Mm-hmm.
And so she's trying to do that by imagining, getting them to imagine that the sand particles are like molecules, if you like. But they haven't settled enough that the water's clear to be able to visualize
the level of the sand,
that analogy,